Good morning. Kindly take down all the citations today I am going to mention, because all these cases would help you in getting deviation of gravity of the offense and lesser punishment. Number first one, Rupinder Singh Sandhu versus State of Punjab, 2018, 5 Supreme Court, 3-436. There, some of the witnesses seems to have been planted, and the Supreme Court has held that these witnesses were planted only at the time of conducting post-mortem and the inquest report. Therefore, the accused number one was given punishment only under section 323, even though charges were there. 302 and the lower court convicted under section 304 part 2. This is most important. Then question of 306, Vajnath Kondriva Kanke, State of Maharashtra, 2018 5, Supreme Court 345. Therein, because there was suicide note, that is not sufficient to convict the accused under section 306. Only because the guilty mind and criminal intent was there, that is not sufficient. This is an employer and employee's case. Then again 306 case, M. Arjuna vs. State of the Inspector of Police, 2018-4, Crimes 517. There, having executed promissory note, since not repaid, he uttered some words, abusive words, but that itself is not sufficient to constitute offence under section 306. Then case of 307, the court, instead of convicting the accused under section 307, convicted under section 325, Subhash Chandra Bansal vs. Gyan Chand and another 2018-1-342. Then in case of Rubinder Singh Sandhu, 323. In Kumar vs. State, 2018-5, Supreme Court 231. Even conviction under section 324 was set aside. So this will help if you go through the entirety of the judgment and conduct the trial. The main thing was that you have to elicit how the witnesses, the eyewitnesses which were not available in the FIR and no possibility of participation at the time of scene, and the inquest report having been prepared, the availability of particulars of the witnesses, then the postmortem certificate, reaching the deceased body to the hospitals, all these things you should concentrate, and particularly all this you should take to investigating officer at the box. You must put a question stating that this area of investigation you have deliberately tainted. This area of investigation you deliberately avoided. This non-examination of witnesses was deliberate, or you would have suggested that you would have examined that those witnesses but retained their statement, because if it is produced before the court, it may affect the prosecution case. This is the way you have to conduct this criminal trial. Best wishes.